So what we've got here, this is a work called Union, and the four flags that we have here are actual or proposed versions of the Union flag that existed over the years, and so they run chronologically from this end through, and I'll just speak very quickly about each of them. So when the kingdoms of Scotland and England and Wales, as they were at the time, first came together, it was decided that the flag that would be created would be the George Cross sat on the top of the Stonehenge Cross. Now obviously there was some resistance to this in Scotland, so there's unofficial documentation of this version of the flag being made. There's an etching of a version of this flag flying over a different castle. So then moving across to this one, in the 1600s, Ireland was part of the Union by this point, and it was decided that Ireland needed a visual representation of the flag, and so the harp was introduced into the centre of the flag, but it was only actually in existence there for about 2 years, I think it was 1658 to 1660, when Charles II decided he didn't like it and just took it out of the flag. There's a huge leap in time here, so then this flag came out of a project of reflag in 2003, where it was a very well-meaning project, where it being that to better represent the multicultural makeup of the UK, the colour black should be introduced into the flag. And so, unsurprisingly, it never really went anywhere, but it was a genuinely kind of well-intentioned project to try and bring that about. And then the last one that we have here, in 2007, the MP for Wrexham, Ian Lucas, raised the very valid point that still there's no visual representation of Wales within the flag, and so proposed the introduction of the dragon into the centre of the flag. Again, that was something that was proposed to Parliament but never really went anywhere. And so, my interest in representing this is very much this idea that we live under this banner of the United Kingdom, we live under the literal banner of the Union flag. But this idea of the United Kingdom, I would question that we've ever really been the United Kingdom. I would question that right now we're probably less united than we've ever been as a kingdom. And when you look back through the history of the flag, and you pull out this kind of genuine alternate history,